Hi, I'm Jorge Atiles, and welcome back to Energy Express on West Virginia Public Broadcasting. I am so happy to be here with you today, amigos, and I will gonna be reading a new book called Gustavo. This book was created by Flavia Drago, and she's a Mexican author. Gustavo is a ghost. He's a very shy ghost, and more than anything, he wants to make a friend. So this story is gonna be quite interesting. I'll throw in there a few words in Spanish too, for those of you who understand Spanish or are trying to learn Spanish as well. Un fantasma tímido, we will say in Spanish. And as you can see, there's a little picture of the ghost playing by himself, trying to play tennis, poor thing. So Gustavo was a ghost and he enjoyed doing the normal thing that paranormal beings do, passing through walls, making objects fly, and glowing in the dark. Este fantasma le encantaba hacer las cosas normales que hacen los fantasmas. Le gusta las cosas paranormales, le gusta pasar por a través de las paredes, le gusta hacer que los objetos vuelen y también le gusta brillar en la oscuridad. You can see in this picture, you know, where he's sitting in his home, there's daddy, there's mom, and he's trying to do things around the house. But there was something in the world that he loved more than playing the violin. Él le gustaba jugar el violín, pero realmente quería hacer algo mucho más. Cualquier otra cosa. Well, just about anything. Gustavo was secretly in love with Alma, the prettiest monster in town. But he also had a problem. Resulta que el fantasma, Gustavo, estaba secretamente enamorado de una chica llamada Alma, el monstruo más lindo de todo el pueblo. Pero él tenía un problema. Making friends was terrifying to him. You can see here how he's surrounded by people, but he didn't know how to make friends. No tenía el coraje para hacer amigos. Gustavo had never dared to speak to any of the other monsters. Él nunca se atrevía a hablar con los otros monstruos. He tried getting close to them. You know, se acercaba a ellos disimuladamente in many different ways. But even when he was right in front of them, they just couldn't see him. I guess that's the problem of being a ghost, right? Cuando uno es un fantasma, a veces la gente no te ve. Gustavo longed to be part of something. More than anything, he wanted to make a friend. Él quería más que nada hacer un amigo, tener algún amigo. Y se decía, I have to be brave. I have to let the others see me. En pocas palabras, él pensaba que tenía que ser más atrevido, que tenía que dejar que las otras personas lo miraran. So he decided to send a letter, a very special letter, and the letter read like this. Dear monsters, I would like to invite you to my violin concert, which will take place at the Day of the Dead party next full moon at the cemetery. I will be thrilled to see you there. Signed, Gustavo the Ghost. Él mandó una carta muy especial a todos los monstruos y los invitaba a que vinieran a oírle tocar el violín, un concierto de violín. Y el violín, él lo iba a tocar en el lugar del cementerio donde se celebraba el Día de los Muertos. Ahí iba a haber esa fiesta. Y él estaría encantado si ellos pudieran venir a verle tocar el violín. As the days went by, Gustavo couldn't stop thinking, what if no one shows up? What if they don't like my music? What if they don't like me? Except tonight was the night, and this time he couldn't hide. Gustavo estaba súper preocupado. Él no podía dejar de pensar, ¿y si nadie viene a mi fiesta? ¿Y si no le gusta mi música? Y peor, ¿qué tal si no les caigo bien? Pero llegó el momento y él estaba ya listo para tocar. The moment arrived, he couldn't hide anymore. When he arrived to the cemetery, he noticed that not one soul has showed up. Nadie vino al cementerio en ese momento. So all alone, Gustavo did what he loved most, and the music made him happy. So happy that he glowed, and how he glowed. Como nadie había venido a la fiesta, él empezó a tocar el violín, que era lo que más le gustaba. Y al tocarlo, la música lo emocionó. Lo hizo brillar en la oscuridad. De repente se oyen voces que dicen, ¡Gustavo! Y Gustavo se sonrojó, como ven. And then all the friends that he invited were there. And they were saying, we are so sorry we are late. We wanted to get you flowers, but we got lost instead. And then we heard your music, and we saw you glow. we really love your concert. Would you like to hang out with us? Cuando los amigos vinieron, dijeron, perdona que llegamos tan tarde. Queríamos traerte flores, pero nos perdimos. Pero entonces escuchamos tu música y vimos que estabas brillando en la oscuridad. Y nos encantó tu concierto. ¿Te gustaría ser amigo de nosotros? From that moment on, Gustavo's life changed. And everyone discovered that even if he didn't talk much, he was the best at helping and protecting his friends. Desde ese momento, la vida de Gustavo cambió. Y todo el mundo descubrió que a pesar de que él no hablaba mucho, era la mejor persona, el mejor fantasma en ayudar a los demás y en proteger a sus amigos. But mostly, Gustavo never stopped surprising them. Él nunca paró de sorprenderlos. And they never stopped loving him. Nunca dejaron de quererle. Y aquí se ven todos juntos, disfrutando de una fiesta juntos. They're right here, all together. Gustavo and his friends, hanging out, having a good time. And that really tells us something. I'm so glad that this author wrote this book. This book is about, even though when you feel invisible like a ghost, even though when you don't have the courage to make friends, even though when you are hanging around other people, hoping for them to notice, what he did, he used the best of him, and the best of him attracted others. So I hope that this book inspires you to also make friends, and also put the best of you forward, because it pays off. Enjoy Energy Express this summer. We are so happy that you are part of WVU Extension and this program, and we are very thankful to West Virginia Public Broadcasting for being a partner. Have a great summer.